So, Rod Stewart, it is so good to speak with you. Hey, and congrats on Swing Fever. It's so good.
It's such a happy album, you know. Every song is a fast song. I didn't want to do any slow songs because I'd already done that on the American Songbook. So I said to Jules, everything's got to be up-tempo. We want to make people dance, put a smile on their faces in this very dark period that we're going through in this planet of ours.
You launched the album with a surprise gig at London's Pancras Station with a big band, the whole shebang. How was that?
Oh, it was wonderful, because you may or may not know, both Jules and I are railroad phenomenal, you know, modellers, and we loved the hobby. So being in a train station, we were very joyous, but it was absolutely chaotic. The great thing is they all left with big smiles on their faces. It didn't sound great, but it was okay.
Oh, you look so in your element.
It's a thought that counts.
So is Swing your thing now?
It always has been, darling, you know. When I grew up, you know, I was born just after the war finished, so there was a lot, in my household, there was a lot of Glenn Miller and Benny Goodman being played by my parents and my brothers and sisters. So I grew up with it. That's why I know all these songs. I didn't have to learn them, I just know them.
Every time it rains, and it's from heaven. Don't you know each cloud contains, and it's from heaven.
You've been tinkering on your model train set now for decades. It's a pretty unlikely hobby for a rock star. What do you think? Is it a form of mindfulness?
Yeah, of course. It's three-dimensional. You've got the electrical side of it, which I'm not great at. I need help there. Then you design your buildings. You look at buildings in Chicago, because mine layout is based around 1940s, when, you know, the diesel took over from steam, and it's like in between, you know, Chicago and New York, so there's massive skyscrapers. But it's just, and Jules is the same. We go into our workshop or our train room, and the whole world can bugger off. You know, I think every man should have some sort of a hobby to get away from the, not necessarily I'm speaking for myself, but the stresses of life. I don't have a stress life.
Oh, look, you're also a massive Celtic fan. In fact, I hear recently you had your love immortalised in the form of a tattoo.
Yeah, right across here. I got it done in Australia, actually, in Melbourne.
Oh.
When Celtic beat Rangers. I'll show it to you if you want, but I've got to undress.
Go on. Oh, I'll say yes to that.
Okay. You see it?
Looks good. You look good. And I got Rod to take his shirt off.
I'll tell your viewers.
You must miss Big Ange.
Oh, do we? Yeah. He does see the funny side of it, though, because every time he'd beat our arch enemy Rangers, I'd send him six bottles of Australian red wine. So when he left, I asked him for it all back. But we do miss him. He's working wonders with Spurs.
Hey, when you were last in Australia, you visited a pretty iconic Aussie shop. I'm talking Bunnings. What did you get there?
I can't remember now, but I used to love going there, yeah. Oh, my God, the sun's come out in Great Britain. Oh, I must go outside. We've had like 2 months of cloud and the sun's come out. So, yeah, I love Bunnings. It's great.
Any chance you'll put the band back together and swing on down to Australia soon?
Well, Jules and I both want to do it. Certainly one of my favourite places to tour in the world. I love the Australians and New Zealanders. With humour-wise, they're so close to the British. You know, we just laugh about the same things. And they're the best audience. I love them. I love you, Australia.
Sir Rod, it has been so great chatting with you, but your people are wrapping us up. You've got to go.
Okay, darling. You don't have to stop yet.
Well, I think we do. I think
I
your people.
Half an hour.
Oh, well, I'd love
right,
to
Alex?
Chat.
No, sorry. It's just we've got a couple of other interviews.
Oh, shit. Okay. Thank you, darling.
See you soon. Bye, Rod.
Bye-bye.